各位现场的法师，还有菩萨们，还有线上的法师菩萨们，大家晚安，阿弥陀佛。
Good evening, venerables here at the site, and our fellow friends, and also all the venerables and friends online. Good evening, 阿弥陀佛。
今天很欢迎大家来参加今天的法鼓讲堂哈。那今天的法鼓讲堂蛮特别的哈，第一个就是时间很特别，对不对哈？我们一般都是礼拜三哈，那我们今天是在礼拜一哈。那本来我以为大概没有什么人来哦，那今天这么多人呢哈，而且还有很多是好像平常比较少见到的面孔哈。
So actually, first of all, we would like to bid you warm welcome to the Dharma Talk. As we are aware, this is a very special time and very special occasion this evening because normally the Dharma Drum Talk will be held on Wednesdays, but today it's on Monday. And we're very delighted to see so many friends here. Originally, we expected very few people, but we're delighted to see so many of you, and even it includes people that we seldom see here in the monastery for the talk.
我知道现场还有一些是本来是佛学班翘课来的。
I also know that some of you are just from the, you know, the Buddhism beginner's class, and you just skip your class for the talk.
所以可以想见我们今天的讲座非常的有吸引力哈。
So we can imagine how popular this talk is for tonight.
那我们今天的因缘真的非常的特别哈。那就是因为一个因缘的关系，那我们就能够邀请到我们的讲者来到我们龙禅寺。那我们的讲者是天真全基讲师啊，他的中文的法名是这样子哈。
Okay, so out of the very, very extraordinary conditions, we have this talk arranged this evening. We are very happy and very honored to have our speaker, Roshi Anderson. His Dharma name is Tenshin Reb Anderson.
他是一位非常有名的日本禅朝洞宗传承的老师，铃木俊荣。可能很多人看过铃木俊荣老师的书，就是《禅心初心》。那他是他的弟子，第一代的弟子，第一代的。
So he is the first generation Dharma heir of Roshi Shurun Suzuki, and their lineage is Cao Dong Zoto, Zen Japanese Zen tradition.
那在旧金山有禅中心，那还有一个绿谷农场啊。那天真全基老师呢，在这个禅中心，旧金山禅中心也担任了十多年的住持。
So and they have a Zen meditation center in San Francisco, and also a Green Gulch farm there.And Roshi Anderson has served for many years, more than 10 years, for the Zen Meditation Center.
那他本人也修行啊，也超过将近50年哦。现场可能很多人都还没有超过50岁哈。
He has been practicing for more than 50 years. I forgot to mention that many of you may be familiar with the book written by his teacher, Shunrun Suzuki, that is Zen Mind, Beginner's Mind.
所以这样的一个修行的历程，还有在跟着一位老师在西方，在开拓这个禅的生根，弘化，这样的一个经历，我相信是非常非常精彩的。所以我们今天定的题目是禅
修行
与我哈。
Okay, I had the right. So actually,
帮你那个忘记了。
我说这样的一个历程。
Right. So actually, all these cultivation and practices have actually resulted in very, very rich and abundant practices.And especially after Roshi Anderson followed a very, very outstanding teacher and practiced for so many years, there's certainly a lot to be, you know, learned from his talk this evening. So that's why we have a talk this evening, Zen, Practice, and Me.
那我们接下来就来欢迎天真全基老师。好
，So let's join our palms and welcome Roshi Anderson。
我们要鼓掌吗
？Applaud. Yeah, sorry. I said 我说合掌，抱歉。
Right. So we start the chat.
那刚刚因为我们那个天真玄机老师呢有跟我们分享，就是他希望说在开始之前呢，请大家一起合掌哈，来诵那个开经偈。Roshi Anderson invited us to chant the opening lines written by Empress Wu. So those of you who know about it, you can chant it in your language. Okay, in Chinese, I will lead the Chinese, and Roshi will chant in Japanese. If you know the language, you can chant in English as well.Okay, so maybe you can tell us the meaning for our audience here who do not speak Chinese, the lines.
Say it in English?
Yes.
An unsurpassed, penetrating, and perfect Dharma is rarely met even in 100,000,000,000 kalpas. Having it to listen to and accept...To remember and accept, I vow to taste the truth of the Tathagata's words.
好，那我们在座就请菩萨们合掌呢，来诵这个开经偈。好，好。无上甚深微妙法，百千万劫难遭遇，我今见闻得受持。愿解如来真实意。
I heard that Empress Wu invited Zen teachers to come to her palace and teach her.
我听说呢，午后呢，她常常会邀请一些就是禅师跟老师呢去教她。
I'm going to make a statement.
我将要做一个宣誓。
And that was it.
And 刚刚那个就是我的宣誓。
I will make other statements.
我也会做其他的叙述。
Which I am sincerely offering to you.
那我很诚恳地把这些讯息呢传递给大家。
But what I offer is something to have dialogue about.
那我想要跟大家分享的，想要传递给大家的是，想要跟大家对话的内容。
I appreciate that you are able to bow in this direction to Shakyamuni Buddha.Who you couldn't see.
我非常的欣赏大家能够就是向上问讯这件事情，特别向上向佛陀问讯，特别是对着大家所看不到的这个对象来问讯。
I heard that a long time ago in India.
那很久以前呢，我从印度那边听到过一个事情。
There was a visible Shakyamuni Buddha.
世尊是不可见的。
Now we have statues that are visible.
那我们现在有可见的佛像。
But the real Shakyamuni Buddha, we cannot see with our eyes.
但是真正的释迦牟尼佛呢，我们没有办法用肉眼来见到。
But that Shakyamuni Buddha is here right now.
但是世尊就在这边跟我们在一起。
And you can see it with your heart.
那你可以用心来看到它。
I also heard that Shakyamuni Buddha gave teachings.
我也听说释迦牟尼佛呢，给我们教法。
In India.
在印度。
Thousands of years ago.
在几千年前，世尊就来传授教法。
In Sanskrit, they call these teachings Buddha Dharma.
那大家就称他的教法称为佛法。
Now, here's this another statement.
那现在我要做另外一个宣誓。
Buddha Dharma
所谓的佛法
has no beginning
没有开始
and no end
也没有结束。
The Dharma which Shakyamuni Buddha gave in India
世尊在印度所弘传的佛法
Some people say that was the beginning of the Dharma
有人说那就是佛法的开始
But I say that was not the beginning
但我会说那不是开始
That was a very important moment of Buddha Dharma
那是佛法传承过程当中一个很重要的时刻
But before Shakyamuni Buddha gave the Buddha Dharma,
在世尊开始传授佛法之前
from beginningless time,
从无始以来
the Buddha Dharma was being given.
事实上佛法就一直不断地在流传了。
And after Shakyamuni Buddha stopped living in this world and stopped giving Buddha Dharma,
在世尊入灭之后，在世尊不再宣传佛法之后
，The Buddha Dharma has continued.
佛法呢，还是持续着
，to be given，
还是持续的在给众生
，with no pause，
中间并没有任何的停顿
，until now，
直到现在此刻
，and it will continue from now on，
而且它会不断的继续的持续下去
，for us to。Listen to,
让我们可以聆听到佛法
and accept,
而接受佛法
and understand,
并且了解佛法
Then there's a story.
然后呢，我们有一个故事
about a school of Buddha Dharma.
那有一个佛法的一个宗派。
Called Chan,
叫做禅宗。
And people say,
那有人说
that Chan started,
禅呢就在那里开始
in China.
他人家有说，禅宗是在中国开始的。
I agree.
我同意
that what appeared in China,
在中国出现的。
Appeared in China.
它是在中国出现的。
But what appeared?
但是真正出现的东西呢
？Was the Buddha Dharma?
是佛法。
And what appeared had no beginning.
那真正出现的那个东西其实并没有开始。
And no end.
无始而且无终。
So the way Zen appeared in China about 1500 years ago.
在十五。在大概1500多年出现在中国的禅宗呢
？We cannot see.
我们看不到。
And whatever appeared there 1500 years ago，
在1500年前出现的那个东西
，was the Buddha Dharma，
就是佛法
，which did not start，
并不是在那个时候开始的
，where it appeared。
并不在那个时候，那个当时当下，那个时候出现那个东西。
And when what appeared disappeared，
当它消失的时候
，That was not the end of Buddha Dharma。
那也不是佛法的终结的点。
It continued up till now。
它持续延续到现在。
This is a conversation piece。
这就是我们所谓的叫做对话式的和平。事实上，他刚刚跟我讲，就是这个是一个他讲的一个简单的句子，但是好像是真的，但是他会有一些发人深省的内涵。那我们继续进行这样的对话。
For me, I use the word Zen.
那我用禅这个字
as a synonym
当做一个同义字
for Buddha Dharma，
等于是佛法的同义字。
And I understand that other schools of Buddha Dharma.
那我也了解说，其他的佛法的宗派呢
，use the name of their school.
用他们自己宗派的语汇
as a synonym for Buddha Dharma.
当做佛法的同义字。
And I think that's fine.
我觉得那样子很好。
I was asked before I came here, before I came to Taiwan, I was invited to come and give a talk here.
在我来到台湾之前呢，我受到邀请，然后来这边来做一个这个讲座。
I was asked what I would like to talk about.
那有人就问，他们邀请的人就问我说，我想谈什么？
And I said, "What would you like me to talk about?"
那我就问说，那你们想要我谈什么呢？
And the suggestion that came back to me,
好，那给我的建议的题目呢？
Was Zen practice and me.
就是禅修行与我。
And I thought, very good.
我觉得这个题目非常好。
There's many reasons why I think that this is a good topic.
那有很多理由呢，让我觉得这个题目非常好。
Or a good statement.
或是这是一个非常好的叙述。
Because Zen practice.
因为禅修行。
Is me.
就是我。
And I am Zen practice.
那我就是禅的修行。
Zen practice is you.
那禅修也是你。
And what you really are is Zen practice.
那你真正是什么人？你真正是什么？也就是禅修。
What I really am is Zen practice.
我们真正是什么？就是禅修。
And Zen practice is the way I find out what I really am.
而禅修呢，就是我发现自己真正是什么样的面貌的那个方法。
And like Zen practice, I have no beginning and end.
就像是禅修一样，我也是无始也无终。
Zen practice has no beginning. I have no beginning.
禅修没有起点，我也没有起点。
No one can find the beginning of me.
没有人可以找到我的起点。
No one can find the end of me.
也没有人能够找到我的终点。
I will die soon.
我很快就会死了。
But that's not the end of me.
但那不是我的终点。
And it's not the beginning of me either.
那也不是我的起点。
It's the dead me.
It's
the dead me.
Dead.
It's the dead me.
哦，那是死掉的我。
I heard about Zen when I was quite young, like you have maybe.
我在听到禅这件事的时候呢，年纪很轻，就像是很多在座各位一样，年纪很轻。
And then after some time, I heard about certain kinds of Zen training.
那在过了一段时间之后呢，我就听到一种某种的禅的那种修行的训练方法。
For example, training in sitting upright.
就譬如说训练大家呢能够这个盘腿，然后正襟危坐这样子。
And still.
坐在那边不动，如如不动。
And silent.
然后呢，安安静静的，如如不动。
And so I tried.
所以呢，我就试试看喽。
But I had trouble practicing it on a daily basis.
但是呢，我发现说每天每天来练习这样的修行方法是有点困难的。
I heard that the training in Zen is a daily practice.
因为我听说禅修的那个练习的话，应该是每天每天都要去练习的。
But I couldn't do the sitting on a daily basis.
但是呢，我不能够每天没有办法每天打坐。
At that time, I did not understand.
在那个时候，我不太了解。
That I was practicing.
其实我不了解，我正在练习，正在修行。
On a daily basis.
其实我不了解，我当时已经开始每天每天都有在修行了。
I did not understand.
我不了解我自己在修行。
Who I really was.
而且我也不认识自己真正是谁。
So I thought, since I did not understand that I was practicing every moment,
事实上，就是我发现说，哎，我不了解自己，其实时时刻刻每一念都在修行。
Every day，
每天都在修行。
I thought that if I went someplace where many people were coming together to practice，
那我猜说，如果说我去参加很多人都一起在共修的那样的地方的话呢
？That maybe they would support me，
他们可能会支持我，然后呢，让我修行的更得力。
To practice every day，
让我能够每天都能够修行。
So I traveled thousands of miles。
所以呢，我长途跋涉千里。
From the middle of North America，
从北美的那个中间的地方呢
，to San Francisco，
一路呢长途跋涉跑到这个旧金山的地方。
Because I heard there was a Zen center there，
因为我听说旧金山那边有个禅中心。
With a teacher，
有个老师
，and a sangha，
然后还有个僧团。
And when I got there，
那我到那边的时候呢
a funny thing happened，
就很有趣的事情就发生了。
I went to the place where the temple was， to where the address was。181 Bush Street.
Bush Street.
Bush, B-U-S-H. 181
Bush Street.
Yeah.
好，所以我看到那个地方的地址写的是181号布西街。
In San Francisco.
哦，就在那个旧金山的地方。
So I went to that door that said 181, and I knocked on the door.
好，我就去了那个地方，然后照着那个地址，然后就敲敲那个地址上面写的那个门。
And an old Japanese man opened the door.
啊，那一位非常年老的这个日本的男士就来开门了。
And he looked at me.
然后就看着我。
And made a gesture that I could go in.
然后呢，就做了个手势邀请我走进去。
So I went in.
那我就进去了。
And then I think maybe somebody else made a gesture.
啊，那可能就另外一个人又做了个手势。
Showing me a place to sit down.
那他就指示我那个示意我可以坐下来，坐在那个位置上。
So I did.
所以呢，我就坐上去了。
I was 23 years old.
当年我23岁。
And I looked around the room.
好，那我看看那个空间，那个房间。
And I saw many old Japanese men.
看到很多老的那个日本的男士。
Smoking cigarettes.
他们在那边抽烟。
And although I didn't exactly know much about Go，
虽然我不太了解那个 Go is a kind of chess game， right？ 不太了解那日本的围棋。
I could see that they're playing Go。
我可以看到他们就在下那个日本围棋。
And I sat there and watched for a while。
然后我就坐在那边看着他们玩。
And I thought maybe this is not the Zen center。
可能这里不是我要找的禅中心吧。
So I said to one of the men，
我就对他们其中的一个男人说，
Is this the Zen center, the Chan center？
这里是禅中心吗？这里真的是禅中心吗？
And he said no，
他说不是，这里不是禅中心。
It's next door，
哦，他在隔壁。
So I went next door，
那我就到隔壁去了。
And the address next door was 181，
那隔壁的那个地址就是181号。
B。
B。181B。
That was 181A。
那刚刚那间是 181A。
And I knocked on the door。
好，那我又在敲门了。
And the door opened。
好，那门又开了。
Now I was expecting to meet the teacher at this temple。
当时呢，我希望是来应门的是老师。
The teacher named Suzuki Shunryu，
就是那位铃木俊龙老师
，who is the founder of the San Francisco Zen Center，
就是我们那个旧金山禅中心的创始者
，and the person who ordained me as a priest，
就是他帮我剃度的，让我成为一位禅师
，and I was expecting him to be there，
我以为他会在那儿
，and I heard he was about 62，
听说他当年那个时候应该是62岁。
So the door opened, and there was a Japanese priest.
好，那门一开呢，就看到一位日本的这个僧众。
Shaved head.
他头是
robes，
然后就穿着僧袍。
But he looked like he was in his 30s.
看起来，但是他看起来只有30岁的样子。
And I thought.
嗯，那我就想说。
Zen's very good for your health.
哦，那个修学禅法的话呢，对健康非常好。
Actually, it was not Suzuki Roshi.
事实上，他就不是 Suzuki Roshi 呀。
It was a young Zen priest.
那只是一个年轻的禅师而已。
Anyway, I got to the Zen Center, and I started, and I found that because the people were practicing there, because Suzuki Roshi was practicing there.
好，那当然我就走进去啦。那因为很多人在那边修行，而且因为呢，那个铃木禅师在那里修行。
Six days a week.
六天都在修行。
And the other students were practicing 6 days a week.
那其他人也是一个礼拜六天都在修行。
I was able to practice 6 days a week.
所以呢，我也可以一个礼拜六天都在修行。
I went there.
我到那儿呢之后。
To get help.
因为我到那边想要获得协助。
From the teacher.
特别是从老师那边获得协助。
And the sangha.
以及从僧团那里获得协助。
And they did help me.
And 他们真正的帮到了我。
I understood.
我可以了解他们在做什么。
That I wanted their help.
我了解说我需要他们的协助。
That I was asking for their help.
我要求他们的协助。
And I understood they gave it to me.
我也了解说他们把这个协助送给了我。
And so.
因此呢。
For 50 years,
有五十年的时间呢。
I could practice every day.
我可以每天都禅修。
And now I wake up.
那现在呢？我每天醒过来呢。
To understand.
来了解到一件事情。
That we're always practicing.
我们都是在修行的状态。
But if we don't practice,
但是如果我们没有修行的话。
We don't understand.
我们就不了解自己随时都在修行。
That we're always practicing.
对，我们都不了解自己是随时都在保持修行的状态。
It may take many years.
这个过程可能需要好多年时间。
Of practice.
特别是很多年的精进的修行。
To understand.
来了解这一点。
That you've been practicing.
然后了解说我们一直都在修行的。
From beginningless time.
从无始以来都在修行的状态当中。
That from beginningless time, you have been practicing to Buddhahood.
从无始以来都在修行，朝向佛法来修行。
But if you keep practicing, you will understand that.
如果说大家持续的修行的话，你会了解自己都在修行的道路上。
Also,
同时呢
，When I first went to Zen Center,
我第一次到禅中心的时候
，I didn't think I was going there.
我并没有意识到说我去到那里。
To help the teacher.
来帮老师。
I didn't think I was going there to help the Zen master.
我并没有认为说自己去那边是要帮助那个禅师的。
I didn't think I was going there to help the sangha.
我也没有想到自己去那边帮助那个僧团。
Now I understand.
现在我也了解，我就是去那边帮助。
That I went to Zen center to help.
我去禅中心
the teacher,
帮忙老师
and I did help the teacher.
而且我真正帮到了老师
and he felt that I helped him.
他也觉得我帮到他了
and I did go to help the sangha.
那我也真的是去那边帮助到了他的僧团
and they felt that I helped them.
那僧团也觉得我帮助到他们了
so I practiced to receive help.
所以我练习去接受人家的帮助
and to give help.
并且呢提供我的帮助
and I do receive help.
那我也真正获得到人家的帮助
and I do give help.
我同时也提供了我的协助
but I didn't understand that.
但当时我并不了解这件事情
when I was young.
我那个年轻的时候并不了解这件事情真正发生了
now I do.
现在我了解了
it's good to understand.
真的了解这件事情感觉非常好
So you're helping me now.
所以大家现在也在帮助我。
And I'm helping you.
我也在帮助大家。
I'm calling for you.
我来邀请大家
to be compassionate.
来对我慈悲。
And you are calling to me.
那各位也来邀请我
to be compassionate to you.
对大家慈悲。
Even though you may not understand that yet.
甚至说，甚至有些人可能还不了解这件事情正在发生着。
And even though I understand it somewhat.
即使是我已经了解我们这件事情，对彼此慈悲这件事情正在发生。
When I first thought of coming to Taiwan.
当我第一次想到说我要来到台湾的时候呢。
I didn't think.
我并没有这样想。
The people in Taiwan.
台湾的人。
Are calling to me.
正在对我提出召唤跟邀请
，and asking me to come，
邀请我来到台湾。
And I didn't think I'm going to Taiwan。
我没有有没有这种想法说哦，我要去台湾
，to help them，
去帮助台湾的人。
And I didn't think I'm going to Taiwan。
我也没有在想说我要去台湾
，so the people in Taiwan，
因此台湾的人呢
，can help me，
可以帮助我。
But I did go to Taiwan.
但是我就真的来了台湾了。
And the people in Taiwan did help me.
而且台湾的人真正帮了我。
Not just you.
不只是各位。
Also the people at what is it? Fagushan.
法鼓山。
Fagushan.
哦，法鼓山上的人也帮了我。
The people there helped me.
他们也帮了我。
Also, I went down to Hualien.
哦，我也去了花莲。
To see the Toroku Gorge.
哦，去那个泰鲁阁。
I went into the gorge.
然后呢，经过泰鲁阁的那个地方。
But maybe I forgot.
可能我忘记了。
But really, I did not forget. I'm going to the mountains because to honor the mountains.
我忘记说，我其实我到山上其实是为了要荣耀那个山，去赞美那个山。
One of the great Zen masters.
有一位有名的禅师
was named Guishan.
龟山
Guishan Lingyu.
哦，尾山灵佑，尾山灵佑
Guishan Lingyu.
龟山灵佑
And his disciple was Yangshan.
他的弟子是来仰山
And Yangshan means
仰山瞻仰高山
Venerate the mountains.
对，敬礼敬高山
So I did. I went to the mountains.
哎，我真的就是去山。那里去
to venerate the mountains.
去那个敬仰群山。
I knew I was doing that.
我很清楚我正在做那个仰敬群山这件事情。
And now I remember.
那现在我记得
that the mountains called me.
山呢召唤了我。
They called me from California.
他们从加州召唤我。
To come to Taiwan.
来到台湾。
And express my respect.
来对这边的群山表达我的敬意。
And I did.
而我真正的来到这边，对群山表示敬意。
And in Hualien.
那在花莲的地方呢
？There's a Buddhist organization.
有一个佛教的团体。
Which in English is called Compassionate Relief.
慈济功德会。Yeah.
Yeah. It's in Hualien.
它就在花莲。
I didn't know before I went that it was there.
在我去那边之前，我不晓得他就在那里。
But I found it.
但是我就发现了这个地方。
And I went there.
那我就去了慈济功德会。
And they helped me.
他们也帮了我。
They showed me another form of Buddha Dharma.
他们呢，呈现给我看的不同的佛法的修行方式。
And I helped them.
我也帮助了他们。
I ate their rice.
我吃了他们种的米。
I said thank you.
我来谢谢他们。
I bowed to their Buddha.
我对他们的佛像顶礼。
And I gave them money.
然后呢，我这个付的功德款就是赞助他们。
Now back to me.
那回到我身上。
Zen practice and me.
所谓的禅修行跟我。
But before I do that, I want to mention one more thing. Is that?
那在我们进行之前的话，我还想要谈另外一件事情。
When I first went to Zen Center，
那我第一次去到禅中心的时候
，in San Francisco，
在旧金山的禅中心的时候
，to practice with the teacher，
那跟老师修行的时候呢
，and the sangha，
啊，跟那个老师还有僧团修行的时候
，after a little while，
在休息一会儿之后
，people would ask me，
人们就会开始问我说
How long have you been practicing?
你已经修多久了？你已经修行多久了？
And when I was there for about 1 year,
那我在那边待了大概一年的时候，
if they would ask me,
他们如果说问我的时候，
I would say,
我就会说，
1 year,
一年。
After 2 years,
那两年之后呢？
I would say 2 years,
就我就说两年。
After 5 years,
那五年之后呢？
I would say, well,
我就说，
I'm not sure.
我不太确定哎。
I came to Zen Center 5 years ago.
我这个五年前来到禅中心。
But now I see.
那我现在看到的是。
That I was practicing before I came.
我实际上在来到这边之前，我就在修行了。
So maybe I've been practicing 10 years.
所以我可能已经修行十年了吧。
Then after practicing 20 years.
或者是20年。
If people asked me,
那若二十年之后，人家再问我说你修行多久了
？I could see that I was practicing 40 years.
那我可能说，哎，我好像应该是持续修行了40年了吧
？The longer I practice,
那我修行的时间越久
，the more I see,
我就可以看到过去累积的修行的时间。
My practice goes back.
我的修行了累积的
，the more I go forward,
更过去更久远，可以再看到更久远。
But after 1 year,
那在一年之后
，I didn't see that.
我就看不到。
One year was 1 year.
一年就是一年。
So now, back to Zen practice and me.
好，所以回到谈到说禅修与我。
Me or myself.
我或者是我自己。
Has to do with my identity.
跟我的身份认同是有关系的。
So.My identity.
那我的身份认同呢
？Is that I'm a Zen student.
我是个禅的学生。
I'm a student of Zen.
也是个禅的学生。
I've been studying Zen from beginningless time.
我从无始来就在禅修，就在学禅。
That's my spiritual identity.
那是我灵，那是我这个灵性的这种身份认同。
Even I'm actually on my passport. It doesn't have your is your occupation on your passport?
Oh, no. 大家的护照上有会写你的职业吗
？Anyway, my passport is not really my identity.
哦，所以我的其实我的护照并不是代表我的身份。
Although it's a little part of my identity because I do have a passport.
虽然它只是我的身份认同的一小部分，因为每个人都会有个护照。
But my spiritual identity.
但是我真正灵性的这个身份
is Zen student.
就是。禅的学生，禅修的学生。
Is Buddha Dharma student?
我是个佛弟子。
Is aspire my spiritual identity is aspiring to be Bodhisattva.
所以呢，我呢就是希望能够成为修菩萨道，成为菩萨。
But this identity of me, my spiritual identity.
但是这个我的灵性的这样的一个身份认同呢？
Is ungraspable.
是没办法去捕捉到具体捕捉到的。
So, I have this spiritual identity right now.
所以我现在有这个灵性的身份认同。
And when I came to Taiwan, I had a spiritual identity too.
当我来到台湾之前，我就有一个身份认同了。
The spiritual identity I had when I came to Taiwan.
当我来到台湾的那个身份认同呢
？Is not the one I have now.
并不是我现在所拥有的这个身份认同。
But I remember I had one.
但我记得我过去之前有一个身份。
And that I've had many, 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 many spiritual identities.
那我还有好多好多好多好多其他的身份，特别是灵性的身份认同。
Every day I have a new spiritual identity.
每一天我都有新的灵魂的灵性的身份认同。
So the spiritual identity that I came to, that I brought with me to Taiwan, as soon as I got to Taiwan, and I met the people in Taiwan, my spiritual identity started to change.
好，所以当我带着我从美国带着来到台湾的那个灵性的身份认同呢，当我碰到台湾的人的时候呢，它开始的进行了它产生了转变。
Before I went to 法鼓山 before I went there, I saw the people in Taipei.
所以呢，在我去法鼓山之前呢，我就先遇见了一些台北的人。
I saw their vitality.
我看到他们身上充满了活力。
I saw how respectful they were.
我发现他们令人非常敬佩。
How careful they were.
他们非常的小心翼翼。
And when I met them, my spiritual identity changed.
那我当我跟他们互动、跟他们相遇的时候呢，我的灵性的认同也产生了改变。
A new dimension.
一个新的面向产生。
Of my spiritual identity unfolded.
我灵性的一个身份认同呢，产生了一个新的面向，然后开始重新重组。
But I don't mind.
但是我不介意。
I couldn't grasp my old spiritual identity.
我没有办法抓住自己旧的灵性的身份认同。
And I can't grasp my new one.
我现在也不能够抓住这个新的身份认同。
My spiritual identity is constantly changing in relationship to all living beings.
那我的灵性的身份认同呢，是会随着我跟不同的人的互动呢，是持续不断的在做变化的。
That's me.
那就是我。
But that's also Zen.
那也就是禅。
Zen is constantly changing.
禅是持续的不断的在变化。
In relationship to all beings.
特别是在我们对跟众生的关系的转变当中，互动专心不断的在做变化。
The founder of Compassionate Relief. Is she a Zen priest?
那个花莲慈济功德会的那个创办人正言法师也是禅修的人吗？也在做禅修吗？
Do we know? She's not. She's a different school. Yeah. Different. Okay. She's different.
好，所以呢，大家说她不一样，那就是不一样。
And so she's different. So Zen is different.
好，那如果说她是不同的修行方法的话呢，那禅也是不同的修行方法。
She's changing Zen.
她在改变禅。
And Zen is changing her.
禅也在改变她。
In reality,
在实际的过程当中是这样，互相在做转变。
And again, every place I go in Taiwan, if I go to Dharma Drum Mountain, I meet the people there. My spiritual life changes.
所以呢，好，这个东西是一个持续变化的过程。像我去法鼓山碰到不同的法鼓山的人，那我的这个灵性的这个身份认同也就在做不同的变化，在跟人互动当中产生变化。
I went to what is it?Dragon Gate Temple.
我有去一个龙门寺，在台湾有一个。
Is it Long Man Si?
龙山寺哦、oh, ，Dragon Mountain.
Dragon Mountain. 龙山。
龙山寺。
Dragon Mountain Temple. I went there. My identity changed.
那我去龙山寺的时候呢，我的灵性的这样的一个身份认同也跟着改变了。
I didn't do what the people there were doing.
我并没有随着当时在那个龙山寺的人跟他们一起做他们在做的事情。
I didn't take the little.Wooden things and throw them on the ground.
Oh, 没有拿那个把杯的杯在那边把杯。
But I was there with them.
但是我跟他们在一起。
And I changed.
然后我作为说我自己也产生了改变。
And today coming here, I heard about your Zen running.
好，那我来这边，今天我来到这边，来到农禅寺，我听到大家那个农禅寺禅跑这个活动。
And when I heard about that,
那我听到禅跑这个活动的时候呢
，I changed.
我也改变了。
My spiritual identity changed.
我的灵性的这个身份认同呢也改变了。
Everything's changing my spiritual identity.
所以每一件事情都改变我的这个灵性的身份认同的内容。
And remembering that spiritual identity.
那记得这个灵性的身份认同呢
？Is remember and remembering that is changing.
所以记得这个事情在持续的改变的状况。
Is remembering Zen.
就是在记得禅修这件事情。
And the way it's changing,
那它改变的方式呢
？The way it's changing is Zen.
那它改变的方式也是禅的本身。
The way it is isn't Zen.
它的样子就是禅。
Like the way I am right now isn't Zen.
我现在这个样子也是禅。
The way I'm changing in relationship to you is Zen.
我跟各位关系的改变也是禅的过程。
My face is not Zen.
我的脸不是禅。
Your face is not Zen.
你的脸也不是禅。
The meeting of our faces.
我们脸跟脸的互相的相遇是禅。
The giving of my face.
给各位我的脸。
And the receiving of your face.
Face, right? This face.
This face.
Okay, 对，好，接收到各位的脸庞。
My giving my face to you.
把我的脸庞给各位。
And receiving your face.
好，然后接收来自各位的脸庞。
That's sin.
那也就是禅。
So, we have a story in Zen that once upon a time there was a Buddha named Shakyamuni.
好，那有个故事，在禅的故事，有很久很久以前，有一位叫做释迦牟尼的人。
And he was sitting.
And 他坐在那里。
In front of a large group.
就坐在一群人的前面。
And he raised a flower.
然后他就举起了花。
I can't get one of these flowers because they're all in the same thing. But he
好，我不能够连，不能够摘花。
He raised the flower.
好，他就把这个花举起来。
And he twirled it.
好，他就转了一下这个花。
I just did that.
我刚刚就做了这个动作。
And many of you people smiled.
那很多人就笑了啊。
When Shakyamuni Buddha did it a long time ago, only one person smiled.
所以当世尊在做这个动作的时候呢，多年前做这个动作的时候，只一个人笑。
Now almost everybody smiles.
但是现在每个人都笑了。
Is this an improvement?
这个是不是进步呢
？I don't know.
我不太确定。
Anyway, after he spun the flower and that one person smiled, whose name was Mahakashyapa.
所以呢，在世尊拈花的时候呢，只有一个人笑，那就是摩诃迦摄尊者，他就笑了。
He said.
他说
，Oh, then, oh, excuse me, I forgot.
啊，对不起，我忘记了，忘记了。
He raised the flower.
他把花举起来，转了一下。
Twirled it.
转了一下。
And then he winked.
哦，他有那个，他有一个那个眨来眨来眼睛。好，就像他现在示范的动作。
And one person smiled.
啊，就一个人微笑。
Mahakashyapa.
那就是摩诃迦摄尊者。
And then he said.
然后他就说。
I now give.
我现在把这个
the entire treasury
整个的法藏
true dharma eyes
正法眼藏
the inconceivable mind of nirvana
这个什么无有正法眼藏，然后呢，大家看不到了这个宝藏
to Mahakashyapa.
我现在把这个传授给摩诃迦摄。
So, in the Zen tradition, that's the first transmission.
所以呢，在禅宗的时候呢，这个是第一个传法的过程，传法的力。
Buddha to his first successor.
所以呢，佛陀传给他的第一位的这个。
Buddha gave her face and winked.
佛陀呢，把他的脸跟他的那个眨眨眼的动作呢，就转给了我们摩诃迦摄尊者了。
Mahakashyapa smiled.
然后呢，摩诃迦摄尊者笑了。
They gave each other their faces.
他们给彼此他们的脸庞。
This meeting, this giving of the face.
这个意思。
This is Zen.
彼此给彼此那个怎么讲脸庞或者是那个脸色，对那个表情，他们互相的给彼此的那个表情。
And this has no beginning.
那这个其实是一个无始无终的一个过程。
And still going on today.
然后呢？现在还传承到我们这边，还在现在，它会持续到未来。
So the Zen school, what we call the Zen school,
所以所谓的禅宗
，you don't find it in India.
你不是在印度发现它的
，but it was there.
但它已经在，它曾经在那里出现过。
It just looked different.
只看起来不太一样。
So when it came, so in China, it looked many different ways, but one of the ways it looked, we call Bodhidharma.
所以呢，好，在中国也一样，它出现了，然后用不同很多种不同的形式出现，然后呢，它其中一个名就叫做这个 Bodhidharma.
Bodhidharma is one of the ways Guanyin Pusa looks.
是菩
观音菩萨，
观音菩萨，所以那个达摩 Bodhidharma 他的一个呈现的方式就是观世音菩萨。
And before Bodhidharma Guanyin looked other ways in India.
所以呢，在菩提达摩之前呢，观音菩萨的那个样貌呈现的方式是不太一样的，在印度的呈现方式是不太一样的。
Usually a very handsome man.
通常是很帅的一个人。
Often with a mustache.
通常还有那个胡子。
And lots of jewels.
然后身上还有很多璎珞跟宝珠。
A prince.
然后看起来就是一个王子的样子。
A beautiful, compassionate prince.
也是一位非常的庄严而且非常的慈悲的王子。
And now in China we have Bodhidharma who doesn't look like a prince.
好，那我们现在在中国的话呢，有看到一个 Bodhidharma， 看起来不像是个王子。
He looks like a Buddhist monk.
他是一个那个看起来像是一个那个佛教的一个僧侣。
Avalokiteshvara's practice is beginningless.
那其实观音菩萨的修行也是无始的。
Bodhidharma's practice is beginningless.
那菩提达摩的修行也是没有一个起点的。
And then later, after Bodhidharma, people said he was the founder of Zen in China.
那后来呢，人们就说那个菩提达摩其实是禅宗的初祖。
And there's a story.
那还有个故事呢。
That Bodhidharma said.
就说那个菩提达摩就说。
A special transmission.
有一种很特别的那种传法的方式。
Outside the scriptures.
就教外别传。
Beyond words.
不立文字。
That points to the human heart.
直指人心。
And sees its nature.
见性。
And becomes Buddha.
成佛。
So for me, this is the special transmission is meeting each other.
所以呢，对我而言，这样子的很特殊的传法，其实是彼此会遇的一个当下的状态。
And this meeting with each other is not in the scriptures.
所以是彼此相遇，而不是在经典里。
Or outside the scriptures.
或者是在经教之外的，是彼此相遇的那一刻。
But that is Zen practice.
那就是禅修。
The way we really meet each other.
那就是我们真正跟彼此相遇的方式。
And that's who we really are.
那就是我们自己真正的面目。
I'm not just me.
我不是只有我自己。
I'm also you.
我也是你。
I'm not just you.
哎，不只是你。你也是我。
And I'm not just you and me.
也不是你跟我。
I'm you and me meeting.
我们是彼此的会遇。
This is how I am Zen practice.
所以呢，这就是我禅修的方式。
Which means how I am Zen practice is how I'm in relationship.
所以呢，禅修对我而言是我在怎么样的关系当中去修行。
Zen practice is not me by myself.
所以禅修并不是我自己一个人。
Or you by yourself.
或是你自己一个人。
It's working. All of us working together.
而是我们一起来共修，一起互动。
That's my statements.
那就是我的刚刚另外一个宣言宣誓。
And now maybe we have a break.
那我们现在可能就可以先休息一下，稍微休息。
When Japanese monks come to visit San Francisco Zen Center,
那当那个日本的禅师呢来这个旧金山的禅中心来访问的时候呢
，and they come to Dharma talks，
那他们就来到那个这个那个 Dharma talk， 就是那个开始的时间的时候呢
，they're very surprised to see that the American Zen students ask lots of questions。
他们很惊讶，会看到那个美国的那些禅修的学生问了好多好多问题。
In Japan, when a Zen teacher gives a talk,
那在日本的话，当老师禅师讲那个禅师开示之后呢
，the students usually don't ask any questions.
那学生通常是不会问问题的。
And I heard a rumor that you're like that too.
那我听说，我有听说谣言说大家也是这样子，不太会问问题。
So when I was talking before, I looked at your faces, and I thought you really understood me.
那当我在讲话的时候呢，我看到各位的脸，我都觉得大家都了解我在讲些什么。
So I'm pretty much done.
所以呢，其实我讲的都差不多了。
I think you understand what Zen is.
所以呢，大家都了解禅是什么了。
It's an intimate transmission.
它是一种非常亲密的一种那种传法的过程。
And it's going on all the time.
而且呢，是持续在进行的。
But if we don't practice it.
那如果说我们不用这样练习的话，没有这样子的
，we won't understand it.
我们就没办法去真正实际去体验到什么叫禅。所以呢？
Is there anything you'd like to?
大家要不要问问问题呢？提出问题。
Tell me to say.
告诉我，我可以跟大家再讲些什么呢？
Any instruction you'd like to give me?
有没有请各位给我一点指示？
Any questions you'd like to ask?
我任何一些想要问的问题呢？哦，后面有问题。
A question.
我们终于看到有人要提出来问题了。
Behind you?
They're first?
Yeah. Okay. Where are you? Who's the one that's first?
好。
Oh, yes.
好，那我们先请第一位法师来发问。
Greetings, Roshi Anderson. It's very honored to have you here to share with us. And here I have a question, which I would like to understand your opinion. Recently, I read an article which said that many people who meditate think that meditation can do a lot of things, including cure their early trauma. I mean, maybe in their childhood or some psychological trauma beforehand. But several articles said that actually meditation can't do it all. Meditation can't help with those things, those psychological problems we encounter when we were younger, and this problem encountered even including those who teach meditation. Meditation teachers also face this kind of problem, and so I would like to see your opinion about this issue. Thank you.
需要先翻译吗，法师？
就是这边请教老师的一个问题，就是很多在禅修的人都会觉得禅修可以帮助我们很多，然后甚至就是禅修可以解决所有的身心的问题。那可是其实有一些研究的报告，然后甚至有一些在修行的人是指出说，其实像大家在成长的过程可能都会碰到一些早年的创伤、童年的创伤或是等等，那这些其实禅修是没有办法解决这些问题的。那甚至有些已经在教禅修的老师也会面对这样子的问题，所以想请教老师的意见。
A couple things come to mind.
我有几个想到的回应。
One is that sometimes Zen is described as having two parts. One is clean the temple, and the other part is sit.
那通常大家想到禅修就会想到两个部分，一个就是去把那个寺院打扫干净，另外一个就是打坐。
So we do that, right?
We clean the temple
and we sit.
那的确，我们是有清理寺院，然后通常我们也打坐。
And many people associate the sitting with the meditation.
那很多人想到那个禅修就想到打坐。
But to me, they're a process.
但是呢，对我而言，它是一个过程，是同一个过程。
So working with trauma.
所以呢，要处理这个创伤问题呢。
It's like cleaning the house.
就好像是打扫一个房子。
Cleaning the temple.
打扫这个寺院。
After you clean the temple enough, you never completely clean the temple.
那在打扫完寺院之后，其实你没有办法完全把这个寺院打扫的彻底干净。
But you clean enough so you can sit.
那你可以把它打扫到足够的干净，这样的话可以安定的坐下来。
Really calmly and openly.
而且真正是很安定的坐下来，而且是很开放的坐下来。
And then after you sit, you clean the temple.
那在我们打坐之后呢，又回去做那个清理的动作。
And then you sit.
然后再打坐。
And then you clean the temple.
再打扫这个寺院。
So when you clean the temple enough to sit, and then when you then after you sit, when you clean the temple, you can clean it more thoroughly.
所以在这个过程当中，一边打扫这个寺院，一边打坐，然后。
If I have psychological trauma, and I don't take care of it, I won't be able to sit. It won't really be sitting. It'll be some kind of tense, repressive exercise, which is not what we mean by sitting.
所以呢，其实要是没有把它足够的打扫的干净的话呢，你是没有办法安定的坐下来的。
But I don't think we have to completely clean up all our trauma before we can sit quite well.
但是呢，我并不认为说我们必须要把那个创伤全部的清扫干净，才能够真正的坐下来打坐。
So then, let's say we do clean up our trauma temple, and then we sit quite well, but then we can go back and go deeper into the trauma, and into the subtleties of it.
所以呢，我会说，我们可以先把它打扫部分，然后之后让自己可以足够的干净，然后让自己可以安定的坐下来之后，然后呢，再有这个力量，再回去，再更深入的去处理那个创伤的部分，然后不断的处理那个比较细腻的部分。
And then we can sit even deeper.
那我们就可以做到更深入的地步。
And forever.
然后这个过程是持续不断进行的，永远进行下去的。
And sometimes cleaning the temple might require.That the perhaps the teacher recommends that the student go to a professional in treating traumatic psychological background. The teacher may not know how to work with that, do that type of cleaning.
所以呢，有时候呢，你的老师，你的禅修的老师呢，可能会告诉你说，这时候你需要去寻求专业的咨商的服务，因为老师可能不晓得该如何。帮助你去清理那个部分，所以他会建议你去寻求专业的协助。
Or some Zen teachers might be better at working with cleaning the trauma of the temple.
所以有时候呢，老师会可能他比较擅长处理那个方面的这个特定方面的这种创伤经验。
And I might not be so good, but maybe I recommend they go see that teacher.
那可能我不是这么擅长，但是我会推荐你去找另外一个比较擅长处理这样子伤口的或这样创伤的老师。Yeah.
Does that address your question?
这样子有没有回答到您的问题
？Yes. Yeah, please stand up.
I'm very, very beginner of learning Zen. But when you're beginning to starting to talk about it's no beginning and not the end, and it's come to probably I don't know how to explain, my English probably is not precisely good enough to describe how I feel, but I don't know why when you talk about maybe face-to-face or Buddhism and Zen, I just don't know why I just come to tears. And I believe when you talk about face-to-face, and it just feels like very powerful energy goes through, and I thank you.
Thank you for...telling me that. So you can be a beginner, and the beginner has no beginning. There's no beginning to this beginner. But you are a beginner. And I'm like an old man, and there's no beginning to this old man. But I am an old man. But there's no beginning to me or to a baby.Or to a woman who's just starting to practice Zen in this form that you are today. But even at the beginning, you can have this meeting. even at the beginning, you can taste what Zen really is by the meeting. And then, continue.
OK, 所以我们菩萨刚刚就是分享了，就是他刚刚坐在这边听 Roshi 的分享的时候，当他在讲无始无终的时候呢，那我们菩萨感到非常的感动，差不多就是泪这个热泪盈眶。那他是跟我们 Roshi 说，他只是一个初学者。好，但是我们 Roshi 给他的回应呢，就哦，那我们菩萨谢谢 Roshi 给他这样的一个经验，特别是当我们面对面的时候，在交流的时候，那个时刻的感动，我们菩萨觉得非常强而有力。那我们 Roshi 给他回应就说，你就是就是在这个时候，就算是初学者也能够体验那个禅的那个滋味，以一个初学的身份，以目前这个姿态，然后在我们这个当下，然后做这样的互动，获得这样的能量跟感动，然后要继续下去。好，所以要祝福这个菩萨。
Zen Center, San Francisco Zen Center, which used to be next to the Go Club.
好，那我们那个旧金山的禅中心呢，其实就是在那个高尔夫俱乐部旁边。
It's not there anymore. We moved to a different place.
啊，那我们当然我们就不在那儿，我们已经搬到另外一个地方去了。
So we have a beautiful center in San Francisco.
那我们在旧金山有一个非常非常庄严的一个中心。
And we have another one in Marin County, over the Golden Gate Bridge.
在这个金门大桥那边过去的地方有一个地方，另外一个地方。
So this is the Farm Zen Temple.
那个地方是一个禅修，而且呢结合农场的中心。
And we have a Zen Farm Temple.
然后我们有一个禅，然后呢农的这个寺。
And then
禅农寺 So we have 农禅寺 We have farm Zen temple here.
Yeah.
Right here.
That's what I'm saying. This is farm Zen center, and we have a Zen farm center.
我们有禅农寺
And then south of San Francisco, about 200 kilometers.
所以在那个旧金山南部的那个200公里的附近。
In deep mountains,
在这个 Gate Mountain 的地方呢
we have a monastery.
我们那边是有一个寺院。
And some time ago, I was the abbot of that monastery.
那在那之前，我其实在那边担任过住持多年。
And in the summer at that monastery, in the winter we just have practice periods.
那在整个冬天，我们都在修行，精进的修行。
It's closed to guests.
所以呢，它就是不对外开放。
Like when you have retreats here.
就像是我们这边禅期的时候不对外开放一样。
We have 2-3 month practice periods.
我们有两三个月的这种精进修行的时间。
But in the summer, we open up the monastery and let guests come.
所以呢，我们在夏天的时候会开放让这个大众进来参访。
One time, I was having breakfast with one of the guests.
所以有一天呢，我就跟我们的一个我们的访客在吃早餐。
When I was the abbot,
当我那时候是住持的时候
，and the guest said to me, "Are you a student here?"
那学生就那个客房客就说，你是这边的学生吗
？And I said, "Yes."
我说是啊，是啊，是啊。
And I am.
事实上，我也是学生啊。
I was also the abbot.
我也是学生，我也是住持。
Then later, she found out that I was the abbot.
那当然，那个房客后来发现我就是住持。
And she was very happy.
她很快乐，她很开心。
That I said I was a student.
她很开心，说我跟她说我是个学生。
I'm always a student.
我永远是个学生。
So my teacher's book is Zen Mind, Beginner's Mind.
所以我老师的书就是禅心初学。
When you really study Zen, you're always a beginner.
所以呢，如果说你真正在认真的禅修的话，你永远就是那个初学者、初发心的人。
What's Zen today?
所以禅是什么呢？
You don't need to know.
你不需要知道。
Like Bodhidharma.
就像是菩提达摩。
The emperor said to Bodhidharma, "Who is this standing in front of me?"
然后呢，这个梁武帝问他说：“哎，谁站在我面前的是谁呢？”
And the great teacher said, "Don't know."
然后呢，菩提达摩只是说：“我不知道。”
Also, Suzuki Roshi said when he came to America, he liked American Zen students. very much.
所以呢，当那个铃木俊龙禅师到美国的时候，他说：“哎，他很喜欢美国的学生。”
He said,
他说：“你 want a book?”
He said, "In Japan."
他说在日本的时候呢。
People know a lot about Buddhism.
那人们都很了解佛法。
Their cup is full.
他们的杯子都满了。
It's hard to get anything in.
所以你没办法再加入新的东西。
In America, the people don't know anything about Buddhism.
那在美国的话呢，他们都不太了解佛法。
So it's very easy to teach them.
所以很容易教他们，教他们很简单。
Unfortunately, now we know a little bit.
那现在不幸的是，我们知道一点点了。
Anything else you want to bring up?
那有没有在座各位有没有其他想要提出来的看法呀、问题呀或分享啊
？Yes.
I want to express my gratitude. It is indeed a pleasure to have you here.
Thank you.
I have a couple of questions. Why did you, at age 23, to become a Zen student? Number one. Number two, you were mentioning many times about spiritual identity, and your identity is changing when you go into different environments. And I would like to know and understand if you can elaborate and to tell us why your spiritual identity is changing. I have my own thinking and thoughts. Would like to match with yours if my thought is correct. Really appreciate. Thank you.
Thank you for the two excellent questions.
好，那菩萨要您要自己翻还是要我
？Maybe do the can you remember the second? Well, why don't you do them? Do them both.
事实上，好，您可以自己讲哈。对，我觉得自己讲比较懂。
首先，我说的是非常感谢，Mr. Peterson 来这边，带给我们非常大的感应。我个人，因为他刚刚开始的时候，他说菩萨在我们身边，我非常同意。我刚问了两个问题，第一个就是，请问他为什么在年纪轻轻23岁的时候成为 Zen student？ 第二个问题是，刚刚他在说了很多次 spiritual identity 的改变，他去到不同的环境，他就改变了他的 identity。我的心里面有一个答案，但是我希望从他的口中去印证我的答案对不对，我的想法对不对。
那我们 Roshi 的回应是，这是两个非常棒的问题。
So I think I can remember the questions. The first one is, I think she said, why did I become a Zen student, or why did I want to become a Zen student? Okay. At this point, I would say, I could tell many stories.Of why. Maybe when I first started at being at the Zen Center, if you'd ask me why, I would have just 3 stories. Now I have unlimited stories. But none of these stories, nor all of them together, account for how we actually come to the Buddha Dharma.The way we actually come to the study Zen is inconceivable. And I'll stop there for that to be translated.
好，那我们 Roshi 对第一个问题的回应呢，就是说，以现在的我来回应这个问题的话，我会说，我会有很多很多的故事，针对这个问题，我会有很多很多的故事来回应跟分享。那如果说你早年问我的时候，可能只有2-3个故事。所以我想说的重点是说，其实没有任何一个方法可以把我这些所有的故事的全部都来分享，然后来说，这就是我在23岁的年纪开始想要成为禅修的学生或禅师的理由。它有好多好多种的理由，然后其中的重点是说，事实上我们之所以能够走上佛法的道路的 这个过程呢是不可思议的 inconceivable， 无法去真正的完全看到他全貌的，那就是我第一个回应。
However, I can still tell you, maybe I don't know how much time we have, but I can tell you some stories.
但是呢，我还是可以分享一些重要的故事。
One story is, I read stories about Zen monks, Chinese and Japanese Zen monks.
那其中一个故事就是我常常会读一些禅师的故事，不管是日本的禅师故事，或者是中国禅师的故事。
Particularly stories about when they were treated with cruelty.
特别是这些禅师在面对比较残酷的对待的时候，他们的反应。
And how they were able to respond with compassion.
他们可以如何带着慈悲心去当针对当下那种情境去做回应。
For example, there's one story is a warrior came to visit a Zen master.
A
warrior, samurai.
A warrior. Okay, 好，所以其中一个故事就是有一位那个武士呢来到一位禅师的面前。
One of the Taipei metro stops is called Warrior Forest.
哦，台北的那个捷运站有一个叫做武士什么吗？武士大道有吗
？Once a samurai, a warrior came to visit a Zen master, and he said, "Master, please teach me the difference between heaven and hell."
好，所以呢，这位武士来到禅师面前就说啊。法师，麻烦你告诉我，就是天堂跟地狱的差别。
And the Zen monk said, "Oh, I'm sorry, I can't teach you the difference because you are so arrogant and stupid."
啊，那禅师就说啊，真的很抱歉，我没有办法告诉你天堂地狱的差别，因为你实在是又傲慢又愚痴。
The warrior pulled out his sword.
所以呢，这个武士就拿出了刀。
Raised it to kill the Zen master.
哦，准备要把那个，准备要砍那个禅师。
And the teacher said, "This is hell."
然后禅师就说，这就是地狱。
Then he dropped to his knees.
然后他马上就跪下来了。
And said, "Thank you."
真谢谢禅师。
Teacher said, "This is heaven."
禅师说，这就是天堂。
So, when I heard stories like that, I thought.
所以我就听到像这样的故事。
I want to learn that.
那我很想更了解、了解、更深入的了解。
I want to be like that.
我想像那个禅师那样子。
How can I do that?
我要跟怎么样才能够像禅师那样子
？And some other stories were actually, yeah. I told one at Dharma Drum Mountain. I'll tell a different one. There was a monk who lived in a little temple. He was poor, and one night there was a full moon.And he was sitting in his little temple, and he heard some sound, which sounded like someone was sneaking up to the temple.
好，所以呢，啊，所以呢，他在法果山已经讲了一个故事，他这边讲另外一个故事。哎，从有一个禅师呢，他就住在一个小禅寺里面，然后呢，他在那边他很穷，然后在那边修行。突然一天晚上，听到有人走进来，然后声音这样很细很小声，这样小心翼翼走进来。
Probably it was a thief.
可能就是小偷。
So I won't take my clothes off.
所以我就不用把衣服脱下来。
But that monk took his clothes off.
但是呢，那个法师他是把衣服脱下来的。
And threw them out the window.
好，他就把衣服丢到外面去。
And all his other possessions threw them out the window.
另外，他把他所有的财产也丢到窗外去了。
And said to the thief, "Please take all my possessions."
好，他就跟小偷说啊，请你把所有的我的东西都带走吧。
Which I thought, wow.
我想说，哇，好厉害啊
！But then then the monk said, "I'm sorry, I can't give you the full moon too."
然后呢，禅师跟那个人讲说，很抱歉，我不能够给你满月。
I thought that was very cool.
我觉得那样的反应非常的酷。
And I thought, I want to be like that.
我想说，我要像那个禅师那样子。
It's possible, you know.
这是有可能做到的。
Rather than going like this.Like this.
与其紧紧握住，不然把手放开。
But how do you learn that?
那我们怎么学会这件事情呢
？If you don't know how,
如果你不晓得该怎么做的话
，we need training.
我们必须要接受训练。
So I thought, where can I get training?
那我去哪里获得这样的训练呢？
Maybe these Zen monks have training.
哦，也许呢，这些禅师是经过训练的。
So I thought I want to do that training.
所以我要接受那个训练。
Another story.
另外一个故事。
I was in graduate school.
那我那时候在读研究所。
In psychology.
那我研究的就是心理学。
At a big university.
在这个一个大学。
And I had a brilliant advisor.
那我有个非常棒的指导教授。
He was so smart, and he was very kind, actually, to me.
所以他很聪明，而且对我非常好。
And one day.I saw him in McDonald's.
那有一天呢，我竟然在麦当劳看到他。
And he was tall, had a very big head.
那他呢，实际上他长得很高大，然后有很大的头。
And so he was sitting in McDonald's, eating a hamburger like this.
真的，他那时候就坐在那个麦当劳，然后像他这样的姿态，这样在吃汉堡。
The big tall body bent over the hamburger.
真的大的头就这样子整个弯下来在那边吃汉堡。
And although I thought he was very smart, I thought I did not want to be his disciple.
虽然呢他很聪明，但是我那下决定说我不要做他的学生。
I wanted to study with a teacher who embodied the teaching.
所以呢我想要跟一个老师学，这个老师呢他把他的教法呢是用身教的方式来呈
现。And I thought Zen teachers.Would do that.
我认为禅修的老师会这样做，用身教来教育学生。
Also, one day, I was driving my motor scooter.
有一天我在骑我的那个机车。
To my house.
然后我要想要骑着机车回家。
And my house was in a, I had a very nice apartment, but I lived in a poor neighborhood.
那我有个很棒的公寓，但是呢，它是在比较贫穷的区域里面。
By the university.
那就在那个大学旁边。
And I drove by a bar.
那我骑就骑经过一个 bar.
And outside the bar, there were people who were drunk.
那在酒吧外面就很多的那个喝醉酒的人。
And they were like throwing up on the street.
他们就在那边喝醉酒，然后在那边吐。
And punching each other.
然后呢，彼此打来打去。
And harassing women.
然后呢，在那边骚扰女性。
And I rode by my motor scooter.
那我骑着机车经过。
And I thought, I do not want to be with those people.
那我在跟我自己讲说，我不要跟那些人在一起。
I don't want them in my house.
我不要他们在我的房子里面。
And I felt really bad.
我真的觉得当下感受很不舒服。
That these suffering people.
我对他们感到难过。
I didn't want them in my life.
我不希望他们在我的人生当中。
But I could already feel that that was not the kind of person I wanted to be.
我那时候已经觉得我不想要像他们那样子生活。
That was like going like this.
那就是用抓的方式。
Rather than like this.
而不是用放射的方式。
And I thought I wanted to learn how to open to these people.
我希望呢能够去帮助这些。
But I need training.
但我需要训练。
Bodhisattva training.
我需要菩萨道的训练。
So again, I thought maybe Zen will help. Zen training will help me be able to not shrink back.
所以呢，我相信这个菩萨道的训练或者禅修的训练，可以让我不要这样一直往内缩。
From sick, suffering people.
Sick.
Sick, suffering people.
我希望不要像这些人这样子，这个受苦的人一样。
And Zen has helped me.I'm not that way anymore.
那禅真正帮助我了。
Of course, I could become even more open, but Zen has helped me not try to get away from suffering people. I'm not afraid of suffering people.
所以呢，我现在已经不怕那些受苦中间的人或者是生病的人。然后禅帮助我呢，能够更为开放。
Does that make sense?
这样子有。
So that's I could keep going all night.
我可以整个一直整晚都在讲这些故事。
The next part was the next point again. It was.
Spiritual identity.
Oh yeah. So like, my specialty is sitting in Chan halls.
那我的专长就是坐在禅堂当中。
I have spent hundreds of thousands of hours sitting in Zen halls.
那我已经在禅堂当中已经坐了大概是几百几千个小时了。
When I was a young man sitting in the halls, I would sometimes think, how strange that you're living like this.
那当我年轻的时候呢，在禅堂打坐，我就想说啊，你怎么会这样子过这种奇怪的生活，在禅堂一直坐，一直坐，一直坐。
To be a healthy, strong young man and be just sitting in a dark hall all day long, day after day. How strange.
不是很奇怪，就是你年轻力壮，然后身体又健康，怎么会在这黑黑暗暗的这个禅堂一直坐，一直坐，坐在那边，每天都在那边打坐呢？
But little by little, I realized that this is helping people, that I'm doing this.
但是我逐渐的
Many people thank me.For being there doing this practice, they came, you know, from all over the place and said, "Thank you for being here and doing this practice."
对，但是呢，后来发现说，很多人因为我坐在禅堂打坐，
所以 I've continued.
谢谢我，所以因此
And the world supports me.
所以他们有人在支持我继续这样的做。
I'm supported to sit in that hall with people.
所以呢，我因为很多人来跟我。
For 50 years,
跟我打坐，然后很多年都这样子，然后我从他们那边获得很多的力量跟协助。
That's kind of my basic identity.
那就是我的基本的身份认同或灵性
的身份。But then, if I go visit Compassionate Relief,
那如果我去拜访那个，比如说慈济功德会
，I think, well, maybe I should be doing something different.
那我可能就会觉得说，我应该做另外的其他的实践吧。
Or you know, or if I Go to some people who are helping poor people in another way. I think, but maybe I should do that.
那如果说我去那边看到一些帮助穷苦人家的人，我
So my identity is not like I'm a meditation instructor and that's it.
好，那我的身份认同不是说我就是个禅师，然后就是这样了。
If you want me to, I'll do other things.
如果说需要的话，我会去做其他的事情。
If I'm called.
如果说我接受到召唤，我就会去做其他事情。
So yeah, and what my spiritual identity changes by what people call for.
所以呢，我的灵性的身份认同会根据其他人对我的要求、对我的邀请跟召唤呢，做了相应的回应跟改变。
My spiritual identity is Bodhidharma.
所以我的灵性的身份呢，就是菩提达摩。
Who is Avalokiteshvara?
那他身上有带着观世音菩萨的精神。
My job is to listen.
那我的工作就是聆听。
And when I listen, I change.
那当我聆听的时候，我就跟着改变回应。
My spiritual identity is constantly changing according to the situation.
所以呢，我的这个灵性的这种身份认同呢，会跟着相关的因缘来做回应跟改变。
And I feel that's true Zen.
那我认为这才是真正的禅。
Is that you're not fixed?
它不是固定不变的。
In your spiritual identity.
它不是固定不变的一个这个灵性的身份认同。
Even though you may, like I still go every day, I still go to the Zendo.
虽然我每天还是去禅堂。
But I'm not fixed.
但是我不是固定一成不变。
If people say, we don't want you to go there anymore.
当如果说大家跟我讲说你不要再进去禅堂了。
I might say, well, what do you want me to do?
They
say, we want you to come over here. I would give it up.
好，那如果说有人来跟我讲说，哎，请你不要再坐在禅堂了，那我说，那我做什么呢？他说，我们跟着我，你们麻烦你到这边来帮助我们。他就说，好啊，那我就去了。
But if they don't say that, I just keep going to the Zendo.
那如果说你不告诉我离开禅堂的话，我就会继续待在禅堂啊。
I'm very happy to just go. It's a beautiful thing.
因为那是太棒的地方了。
To go and sit like a Buddha.
然后呢，坐在那边就跟佛陀一样，在那边打坐是非常棒的事情。
But if people say, Buddha, would you please come? The Buddha gives it up and goes.
那如果说你跟佛陀讲说佛陀麻烦然后这边帮助我们的话他也会放弃打坐然后来直接去帮助人家。
Buddha is not attached to being Buddha.
佛陀呢不会说执着说他就是佛陀。
Bodhisattvas are not attached to being Bodhisattvas.
那菩萨也不会坚持或者是执着他就是菩萨。
They want to be Bodhisattvas. Bodhisattvas want to be Bodhisattvas so much.That they give it up.
那菩萨们呢，很想成为菩萨，很想成为菩萨的这种程度大到说，他愿意放弃成为菩萨这样的心。
Like they say in Christianity, God so loved, He so loved His only Son that He gave Him to the world.
就像是基督教他们所说的，上帝如此爱他的子，然后呢，他就是这么爱他到的一个极致，是说我愿意把这个自己最钟爱的儿子呢，这个给世人。
I think Buddha has the same heart.
那佛陀也有同样的这样的舍的心。
Again, I could go on.
那同样的这个问题，我也可以继续不断的回答下去。
Anything else tonight? Yes.
请问一下，你学佛有困难吗？你如何克服
？Do you have problems learning Buddha Dharma?
我想请问，就是说，你学禅有碰到困难吗？你如何克服
？So have you encountered any problems learning Buddha Dharma or learning Chan? And how do you overcome them?
The way I overcome it is by conversation with it.If a difficult face comes, a difficult teaching, like a difficult person or a difficult sutra, I believe that my job is to meet that and interact with it. And by meeting and interacting with that difficulty, difficult teaching, difficult person, the practice will come alive.
所以呢，禅师的回应就是说，我碰到问题的处理方法就是，我去面对他，然后去跟他对话，然后呢，不管是碰到不好相处的人，或者是难的经典，那我就是去跟他互动，跟他对话，然后慢慢的修行就会提升起来。
If I have pain in my body, that's difficult practice. That's difficult Buddha Dharma.
如果说我身上在打坐的时候产生疼痛
，But if I meet that pain with compassion and talk with it and listen to it, the Buddha Dharma comes alive.
所以那个痛其实就是佛法。然后呢，当我用慈悲心去面对那个痛，用慈悲心去跟他做对话的话，去聆听他的话呢，那这时候佛法就会整个的活生生的活起来。然后这就是我修行的方法。
And in my particular personality is that I'm quite attracted to difficulty.
那我个人的个性呢，就是我通常会受到那个困难所吸引。
I'm quite attracted to difficult teachings.
那我会受到困难的教法吸引。
In the West, there are some teachings which have almost no one is studying.
那在西方的话呢，其实有一些东西没有人想要去研究。
No Zen priests are studying.
No Zen priests.
Well, in other words, some scholars are studying certain areas of Buddha Dharma.、Mm-hmm. Scholars.
Yes.
But almost no Zen priests are studying.
Oh, okay. 所以呢，其实有一些很多学者研究不同的佛法的领域，但是呢，就是这个 Zen 的这个领域会比较少人研究。
So I go to those things.
那我就会去做这些研究。
It gives me life.
那它会给我生命的力量。
Shall I introduce the second half of your conversation before we proceed to the question?
好，所以刚刚他们其实对在进入到第二个问题之前的话，其实菩萨有问，就您的问的问题是说，他是不是话头跟那个墨照一起用，对不对？那针对这点的话，禅师的回答是说，墨照会帮助话头，话头也会帮助墨照。好，这是他对第一个问题的完整的答复。那第二个问题，菩萨问的是说，你想要知道就是那个只管打坐跟墨照的差别。对不对？以及说他在修行过程当中，就是在顿修跟渐修的过程，或者是他们是不是有用像是坐禅针这样的师
？OK. So the second question that he is trying to address, because first of all, he wants to learn the differences between just sitting Zigen Daza and silent illumination. Because here we practice silent illumination, which so this is one question, and then at the same time.What he learned here is that sometimes Master Xiang Yan will quote the poems by, for example, Chan masters such as Hong Zhi Zheng Jue, and the poems will teach us the state and also the method about how to you know, practice silent illumination. And he wonders, in America, when you practice Japanese Zen, Zikan Dasa especially, do you also adopt similar methods?
You mean, would we adopt some of the methods of Hangzhi?
Uh-huh, or maybe using the poems to as guidance? Or
yes! So, for example, one of the main poems we use by Hangzhi Zhongzhuwei is called Sua Chan.
Zuo Chan Zhen.
Yeah.
Zuo Chan Zhen.
The acupuncture needle of Zazen.
Yeah, a demonition.
Okay. That's one of our main poems, which I study a lot with students. And it starts out the pivotal activity of all Buddhas, the pivotal activity of all Buddhas, the active pivot of all ancestors.
是不是那个坐禅者祖祖基要，然后他的那个核心的教法，然后跟那个是不是有没有现场把是我记不起来背不起来，就祖祖基要，然后那个什么佛佛要基还是之类的，对不对？他们也是用坐禅针来指导他们的修行的。哦，然后那边有举牌说五分钟，剩下五分钟他看到了。
Did you want to say something?
No, no. She's raising the time reminder. There are 5 minutes left.
The first two lines of Zhongzhuwei's poem are very important to me and to Dogen, or I should say to Dogen and me.
所以呢，弘治正觉禅师的这个坐禅针呢，其实对道元禅师跟对我都非常重要。
Dogen, the founder of Japanese Soto, was.For him, Hangzhi Zhongzhuwei was a great teacher.
所以呢，道元禅师，也就是禅宗日本禅宗的创始者，认为说弘治正觉禅师是非常伟大的一位老师。
So he wrote one of his essays is named after that poem.
所以呢，他的一首诗其实就跟着这个诗，
The name of the essay is Sua Chan.
坐禅要集还是那个道元禅师的一个作品，他其实就是跟着这个弘治正觉禅师的名字。
The needle of Zazen, and so at the end of the essay, he quotes Hongzhi's poem.
那在他这个他的那个论点后面，他的写完这篇文章最后呢，他就是引述弘治正觉禅师的说法。
Hongzhi's poem again starts out, "This is about Zazen. This is what Zazen is for Hongzhi."Zazen is the pivotal activity of all Buddhas.
所以呢，坐禅是所有佛的那个最核心的部分。
And Dogen then, after quoting Hongzhi's poem, Dogen gives another poem which he wrote.
所以呢，在他引述完那个弘治正觉禅师的话，他又自己写了一首诗。
Which has the same name.
那又用同样的名字。
And the first two lines are the same first two lines.
那他们前面两行都是一样的两行。
So Dogen understands that Zazen and Hongzhi understands that Zazen is the pivotal activity of all Buddhas.
所以呢，道元禅师跟弘治正觉禅师他们了解到说，坐禅其实就是佛的基要。
And what is this pivotal activity?
那什么叫做基要呢？最重要核心的活动呢？
It is the way Buddhas and sentient beings turn on each other.
那就是人哦，这个坐禅者、修行者跟众生互相的互动。
It's the way delusion and enlightenment turn on each other.
也就是迷跟悟之间的一个交错。
Zazen is not delusion.
那坐禅不是一个悟，一个迷悟。
Zazen is not enlightenment.
它也不是悟。
Zazen is how delusion and enlightenment pivot on each other.
所以呢，坐禅就是那个迷跟悟之间如何去翻转。
And the character, the Chinese character for pivot is also means necessary, yao.
对。
Necessary, essential, and pivot.
所以呢，在那个中文的写法，那个要，就是重要的那个要，就是讲的就是要机的那个意思。
But I like pivot because it shows that the essence of Zazen, the essence of Buddha activity, is the way Buddhas are working with people.
那可是我最喜欢的那个药，基药的那个药的意思，其实是修行者必须要跟人一起互动。
And at the beginning of this essay, Dogen quotes another Zen story.
那在他那个论点之前，道元禅师是有引述了另外一个禅宗的故事。
About Yao Shan Wei Yan. And the story is, Yao Shan is sitting.
耀山坐在那，耀山禅师坐在那儿。
And a monk says, when you're sitting so still like this, what kind of thinking is going on?
所以呢，你坐在这边如如不动，你的内那个里面内心在想些什么？心念活动是什么样子？
And he doesn't say, no thinking is going on.
他并没有说不准有任何心念活动进行。
He says, what kind of thinking is going on in the sitting of the Buddha?Thinking, not thinking.
所以呢，他说的是说，不准，不是不准，不要有心念活动，而是说你观察到那个心念活动，然后呢，它在进行着，然后呢，想跟无想之间的一个进行状态。
In Buddha's sitting, thinking is not thinking.
所以呢，在佛陀他们打坐，在佛打坐的状态当中的话，想跟无想是同一件事。
And not thinking is thinking.
那无想就是想的一种。
The essential activity of Buddha's Swachan is thinking, not thinking, thinking, not thinking. It's not one or the other. It's the relationship. It's the face-to-face meeting of thinking and not thinking.
所以呢，在佛在那个座上面的那个活动呢，其实就是想跟无想之间的互动的连续的过程。
So we use those examples to teach what just sitting is.
所以我们就用这样的一个例子来教导那个止观打坐。
Okay. I think we're supposed to stop now, right?
所以时间大概差不多了哈。
Thank you so much.
非常感谢大家今天晚上的来临。